Hello all. Good evening on this Social Samosa World Social Media Day, Social Media Live session. I would just like to add a small two parts here. One is obviously I'm actually taking time out of the match here, and I just saw that England is playing fairly well. So I would actually finish this quickly within half an hour and let you enjoy the India match. That's more important. Second most important thing is that I believe this is the 10th year that we are actually celebrating Social Media Day, which was started in 2010 by Mashable. So it's actually a fairly momentous time to actually celebrate Social Media Day. Now, most interestingly, I can't see myself on the laptop here. I have no idea why. I'm using Brave browser. It's completely dark. All I can see is a dark screen, but the Social Samosa team just told me that they can see me, and I can see a comment by Ken Roy who says, "We can see you." And I can't see myself here, so this is going to be a very interesting session where I can't see myself. Anyway, let me quickly start. Just for context, Facebook started in 2004 in the university dorms in the US, and it went broadly accessible to the larger world in 2006. Now, just imagine a picture where they actually started in 2006 by saying that, "Hey guys, Facebook is not free. You need to pay rupees 200 to 300 per month depending on your usage." If they would actually said that, would you have considered signing up for Facebook? Is there any way that you have seriously considered signing up for Facebook? Now, this is the kind of question that you ask now for a Netflix or a Spotify or an Amazon Prime. Because they ask you to pay something upfront as a monthly fee, you will actually go through a process of, "Hey, this is worth it. Should we consider an alternative platform that may be better than this one?" So that's how you look at it, right? But just imagine Facebook was free. I mean, I'm saying Facebook because it's still the largest social media platform in the world that is free. Twitter is free. LinkedIn is free. You name the platforms that have existed in the past, Orkut, MySpace, everything were free. There was never any social media channel which had asked you to pay a per month fee to actually access the channel. Because of which, as many people have actually said in an interesting manner, when the service is free, you, the user, are the product actually that they are trying to sell to somebody else, which is a fair statement actually. You're getting something free, so they need to get something out of it in terms of monetary value, so they actually sell your data. Of course, there is a lot of problems in terms of how the data is sold. That's what we are actually going through now. So the point was, when there was a monetary tag attached to it, you value that service more seriously. You try to get maximum out of those platforms. But when there is no value, you actually get addicted to the platform because it's endless supply. It's always there whenever you need, you get addicted. From what I hear, the last numbers in terms of the average time spent per day on social media across multiple platforms is about 2.5 hours. About 2.5 hours in our 24 hours a day, we actually are active on one social media or another. It's usually a multiple platform usage, but we actually spend about 2.5 hours per day, every day on social media. Now, which obviously gets me to this very important question: would you call the time that you spend on social media across the day as productive? Now, just imagine, we start the day. We actually wake up, we just wake up and open our eyes first thing in the morning. And then what do we do? Do we look at the sun? Do we do, I mean, a big prayer to the sun god? No. We actually pick up our phone, which is right next to our pillow. We actually start scrolling through a timeline in any one of the platforms. It could be a WhatsApp timeline, it could be a Facebook timeline, it could be a Twitter timeline, Instagram timeline, you name the timeline, it doesn't matter. You start the day by scrolling through a timeline. Now, how do you end the day? You do exactly the same thing, actually. You actually pick up the phone, it's dark, and the phone is the only thing glowing in your hand. And the last few seconds. Sorry, I had to break the signal at the time. I think in my building where we got act as a connection, almost everybody is on Hotstar right now watching the match, and that probably explains the connection dropout. Anyway, so as I was saying, we actually start and end the day through scrolling the timeline, so which may not be the most productive way to use social media, is what I was saying as earlier. So as a result, the primary discussion around social media right now, what we're actually talking about in a very interesting manner, that it's actually the 10th year that we are actually doing the social media day, is predominantly negative these days. We talk about abuse of data by Facebook, misuse of data by all the platforms, trolling, anger, fake news, negativity. This is literally what we're trying to talk about. Combined with addiction, which is also another problem. We say that kids should not get addicted to something, and social media, we adults themselves are addicted. All this actually points to a time, I mean, points to the fact that we seem to be, or we may be wasting time on social media more than actually making use of it in some way. Most interestingly, I mean, I'm actually part of a couple of WhatsApp groups where I'm actually friends with my alumni right now. When I was in school and college, and like that alumni, I'm actually part of the WhatsApp groups. And when I actually talk about the platforms online, like Facebook and Twitter and etc., there, a couple of people actually get very angry. They actually said, Karthik, you shouldn't encourage use of social media like this at all. That you should actually discourage the use of social media. And they point out to the fact that even Apple actually has an inbuilt tool in iPhones and all, I mean, all kinds of devices that they have, where they actually give you the time that you spend on social media as actually something like, you need to reduce the time consciously. You should not be on it all the time. You should not open multiple tabs and waste time on it. So we need to take charge of the time that you spend on social media. Now, this is quite interesting because all the platforms want us to be addicted to them, addicted to the timelines, and the devices, and Apple is trying to say, curb your time, control your time. Now, let me actually turn the whole thing around, because we seem to be having a problem between devices and the kind of attitude on the platform that we need to have. Let me turn the whole thing. What can you gain from social media? What can you purposefully gain from social media? Is there anything that you can gain at all in the first place? Now, most of the people, when I ask them saying, why are you on Facebook? Why are you on Twitter? Why are you on LinkedIn? Most of the responses generally is, one, it's free, obviously. And I get to interact with interesting people. I get to make friends with people. I get to meet like-minded people. This is probably one of the most common things that people generally say, why are they on social media? Now, my experience is that you can absolutely gain, because even having those friends, meeting interesting people, everything is a good gain. But more than all those random serendipitous gains, which just happens on its own by not any planning at all, there are actually ways that you can make purposeful use of social media and the time that you spend offline if you only plan about it and think about it more carefully, slightly more carefully. It's not a major work actually, but you can go about it. The first step obviously is actually the point is, you need to have an objective for why you're spending time on social media. If there is no objective, you can't actually measure whether what you're going about is meaningful or not. There is no other way that you can look at it. So you need to find a way to measure and get an objective. Why am I online? Why am I on Twitter? Why am I on LinkedIn? At least LinkedIn, you'll be able to answer the question easily. It's an online CV of sorts. And if I put my CV there, I'll get a job at some point. Makes perfect sense. It's a good answer actually. But Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, all those platforms, TikTok, even worse. Why are you there? What do you aim to get out of it? Just random views, likes, that's the kind of thing that we're looking at. It can be a lot more purposeful, again, as I said, if you think in an interesting manner towards an objective. One objective that can actually work very well for you in the long run, which I've experienced personally, is let people be aware who you are and what you are worth and what your interests are. Now, this is literally what you do on an almost like an impulsive basis anyway. If you join Twitter, you actually start talking about the world around you, about yourself, about your interest in a very not so coherent manner. On Facebook, you actually share your innermost thoughts, innermost feelings, everything is shared, and that's largely how you go about it. But they don't actually converge in any point so that people can actually get a much better feel of who this person is. Who is this Karthik who is spending time on Facebook? Who is this Karthik who is spending time on Instagram? They don't actually merge in some point. So the point, again, as I said, is to get the objective right first. First, think of a merger as to what are the three or four things that people should remember about you. Now, this is not rocket science at all. Just imagine how you would pick up a new, brand new smartphone. Now, suppose if I say that this OnePlus 7 is a great phone. If I ask you saying, why should you buy a OnePlus 7? What would you say? You would probably say the screen is very nice. It's very big and there is no notch anymore. The battery life is very predictably good. It's very comfortable to use. The software is very nice. It's not loaded with a lot of junkware. It's very smooth. So you would actually list about four or five points that come top of your mind based on what you've seen on the OnePlus website, based on what Robert Downey Jr. is actually saying in the ads during the match, Those are the points that you will remember, and you would only list about 4 or 5 things about the phone. And then if you go and search, you will find about 10 different more USPs of the phone, and then you will eventually buy it. But top of mind, you would remember about 5 or 6 things. That's exactly what I'm asking you to actually do for yourself as an individual, making it a mix of both personal and professional, not just personal alone, not just professional alone, making it a mix of them. First, start with that. Because these platforms are free, they want you to start by experiencing the platforms and then think of everything else. I'm saying the reverse. Actually, start with yourself. Who are you as an individual? Write down your USPs in about 5 or 6 bullet points. And just imagine that those are the 5 or 6 points that people should remember about you. The more you talk about it online on all those platforms, the more they actually see it and more they remember it. Now, after about 6 months or 1 year, when somebody asks, do you know who Karthik is? They would have actually seen me across multiple platforms. And if I'm consistent with the content about all these things, then it would make perfect sense, because they would immediately answer, Karthik, I know that person. He's good at 1, 2, 3, 4. That's what they would remember. In spite of that, if I'm not going through the structured process and talking about everything and sundry in the world, people won't get a handle of who I am or who you are when you're talking. Now, it's an interesting word I use. People don't get a handle of who you are. And we actually call handles. What are handles? Social media handles, a Twitter handle, Instagram handle. So that's actually an interesting way to frame it. Let people get a handle of who you are by working on your objectives first. What do you stand for? And then talking about it more consistently, and then go about it. The easiest way that I can give you a parallel to this, a very easy way to understand how this works, is like your health in the physical world, in the real world, your health. Now, your health in the real world is made of 2 things. 1, input, what you eat, what you intake as a person, basically. 2, output. It's an exercise. You need to do both to stay healthy. Similarly, what you read online, not just on the social media platforms, but even outside, what you read online is input. Anything that you read online, if you spend time reading crap articles online and absolute nonsense online because it's on a timeline and you keep on scrolling endlessly, keeping on reading it will affect your health, not physical health, but the mental health. So you need to pick and choose what you want to read based on the 4 or 5 topics that you listed for yourself, because that is your USP. You need to know more about those topics so that you can become more curious about them and become an expert on those topics. Not necessarily an expert, but a person that others think this person really knows what he's talking about. It need not be an expert, actually. You can continue to stay curious on the topic also. So that is the intake part. The second thing is the equivalent of the physical health exercise, which is sharing. In fact, there is a question, how do we create content that is relatable and shareable? So don't aim for shareability first. First, just understand whether it stands by your brand or not. You are a brand, you actually listed your USPs. Ensure that anything and everything you share, as much as possible, don't actually go off track, as much as possible, stick within your brand. Whatever you're sharing, is it adding to your personal brand or not? The more you share towards your personal brand, more people will form an opinion that you stand for those topics. The less you do that, let it will go all over the place. It will just completely go all over the place. People won't get a handle of you. So that's largely the kind of example that you look at. Again, another example. Again, with the gym example and health example. During the first week of January, almost every year, by the end of the first week, if you have made a new year, you made a new year, something like a resolution, that you will go to the gym and you will run every single day, say 3 kilometers, 5 kilometers every weekday, and you start running and you hit the gym, pump up weights and etc. At the end of the first week, you would stand in front of the mirror and start looking at your biceps and triceps. Would it be of any use at the end of the first week? No, it won't, obviously. But you would possibly feel something in your head saying, yeah, there is some movement in my biceps. It looks slightly bigger than last week. But it's obviously not true. It's just in your head, basically. The same thing happens even when you share content for just a small period of time. You need to make it into a timetable of sorts almost on an everyday basis. If you share things, if you actually get very, very enthusiastic about what I'm saying now and start sharing for the first week or the first month or first 15 days, don't start looking at the numbers at the end of just that small period. It really won't help. It's like looking at your biceps and triceps at the end of 2 weeks after you hit the gym. It won't obviously help at all. This is a long-term plan, actually. It would need at least 6 to 7 months or at least 1 year for people to notice either your biceps or the kind of content you're sharing. But it will affect. even if you spend about 15 minutes for your own personal brand online and you are extra cautious about what you are sharing, that would really make a difference. Because at the end of 6 months, at the end of 1 year, somebody would be talking to somebody else saying, hey, if you want great content on that particular topic, I've been following that person and she has been sharing very consistently. Almost every week I get one great post from her on LinkedIn or on Twitter. That's exactly what will happen, even like the offline world in gym. Because if you've been running and exercising every single day for 6 months or 12 months, it will show in your body. Obviously, there is no reason why it won't. The same thing happens because people will start looking at you differently through the content you share. Towards this contest, there are two books that are very interesting, that are very relevant. The first one is called, it's actually called The Presentation of Self in Everyday Life. Now, if you had actually seen the Netflix show called Mindhunter, this book was actually showcased in that show briefly. But this is a far more interesting book and a world famous book on that sense. This actually talks about long back. This was written in the 50s and 60s. This book actually talks about how people present a face in front of the crowd who happen to be strangers. And based on what they say in front of strangers, those strangers actually make some kind of mental map of who this person is. Just imagine, this is exactly what we're doing every day on Facebook or Twitter. We are in front of strangers, we say something, the strangers actually create a perception in their mind about who we are. That's literally what we are doing. And that book was actually written in the 50s, 60s using face-to-face communication. This one is on social media communication, where millions of strangers judge us every day, every minute, every second, based on one tweet, one update on LinkedIn, one update on Facebook. Now just imagine, if you are conscious about this fact that millions of strangers judge you, how well or how better would you do things? If the point is, if you're not conscious, you would actually say anything that comes to your mind and people form random opinions about you. But if you're conscious about the fact that people judge you, people take away something from whatever you say, then you will become conscious about your own brand, find out what you need to stand for and do it far more in a focused manner. The second book is obviously an obvious plug because I have just written this book. It's a simple book. It's a very easy hands-on book. It's called Be Social, Building Brand You Online. Of course, that's the book. And there is a phone in the cover also, which is quite intentional. It's a very hands-on and very easily accessible self-help book on how to go about your personal brand online and how to make productive use of social media, which is literally what I'm talking about. It's a fairly easy book. There are enough examples from the Indian, because this is a very Indian book. This is not an international book. There are no international examples. Very Indian. There are enough people that you meet every day on social media. I've actually spoken extensively about them in this book. And there are enough examples that you can get inspiration from and actually go about your own journey. So the next time you spend time on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, you would actually think at least for about 5 seconds, do I need to post this at all? How is this helping me in the first place? Is it adding to my personal brand or not? Then you will pause. If it is completely outside your brand, you need not probably post it also. So think about it from that point of view. The next time you start using any of the platforms, even now you're probably online in multiple tabs, think about a more purposeful way to use these platforms instead of just wasting time on those platforms. Let me just look at a couple of questions here. How important is it to be present on all social media platforms to build a brand? By Kritika, interesting question. I'll just give you one great example. Anand Mahindra. You must have been following him on Twitter. Most people who are on Twitter, he's probably the most followed CEO in India and one among the top 10 in the world. Guess how many platforms he's active in? Is he active on LinkedIn? No. Is he active on Facebook? I have no idea. He may be with friends alone. He is active only on one platform, Twitter. That's his chosen platform. He does it really, really, really well. That's focus for you. Of course, you can argue that is Anand Mahindra. He is the most popular CEO in India. Obviously, he can afford to choose one platform. We are normal people. We are all Aam Janta people. So we need to be at least in more than one platform. LinkedIn is an absolute must because, I mean, more importantly, apart from the professional sense, more importantly, it's got Google juice. Anything that you see on LinkedIn, your profile comes very, very high on a Google result when people name search you. So that's quite important. Twitter, I would say, is equally important because Twitter is one of the very few platforms that is 100% open in terms of content, which again means Google juice. When people search, when people name search or do a topic search, your last tweet, if it's an open tweet, when you don't have a locked profile, your last tweet would actually come on right on top on a Google search. So these two platforms are very important from that point of view, because it's both of them have got Google's blessing. Your profile on LinkedIn and tweets basically, which are up to date and more time-based, they actually come right on top on a Google search. Apart from this, no other platform probably comes this well from a Google search point of view. It is up to you to be part of those platforms. For instance, Instagram is more seen as a personal kind of output as to how you think about the world, what is your opinion, and seen through a visual medium. So absolutely perfectly fine to be there. But just think about, again, saying whatever you share, anything, however small, however insignificant, is it adding to your personal brand? Have you listed a personal brand and is it adding to it at all? There's one more question. I completely agree with everything you're saying, Saloni says, but if I'm convincing a student to build a personal brand on social media, I need to give them reasons. How does a personal brand realistically help people? Now, students are an interesting category because most of the people generalize how students behave. They are like this, they are like that, blah, blah, etc. But just imagine a student who has a good focus on what he or she is sharing on Instagram or Facebook or Twitter or LinkedIn. If there is a content-based theme, there is a theme-based kind of content that's happening in a stream, how would that student stand out amongst millions of other students? Millions of other students stand, I mean, they actually share random stuff online. This one particular student, she actually shares purposeful, interesting stuff as a theme. And it's actually a running theme. You actually look at her profile on Instagram, you see a series of content that means everything together, actually. So you would actually think of them in a very different light altogether. That is one of the great reasons for why students could actually get active on social media, because their first job could actually be because of what they share consistently online, if it happens to be based on their professional interest also. Nikita is asking, how do we create content that is relatable and shareable, which actually connects good to the first question that's asked by Mansi. What does authenticity mean in today's social media world? Authenticity means every single thing, I would say. Because when I actually talked about this book, Presentation of Self, many people confuse that presenting oneself to strangers is faking it. It is really not faking it at all. Presenting oneself is your authentic self. Because you can't assume that you are actually sitting inside a room in your pajamas and you're sharing something with the world. Nobody would know what the real you is. You need to go out to the world. You need to work. You need to study. You need to engage with other people in the world. And at some point, the online and the offline world will collide. When it actually collides and people see that you don't seem to be the one who is actually showcasing himself or herself online, things will come to a clash and your entire brand will come crashing. It is like a very bad brand doing great advertising. Will it work? The ads will work, but when people have to buy the brand's product or service, and if it doesn't actually fulfill what it's supposed to stand for, people will start talking about the brand saying, hey, the ads were fantastic. It's got big stars in it. It's very entertaining and funny and shareable. But when I bought the product, it was such a flop show, man. I am not interested in this at all. That's literally what people would end up saying, right? That's exactly what will happen if you're not authentic online. Just two more questions I'll take. It's only 4:30. There's a question. Should an individual create content on every possible topic that trends? No, that's exactly what I'm trying to say. There will be trending topics, and that's the whole world, actually. But you need to find out what are the topics that you need to stand for. You can't stand for all particular topics at all, and people won't understand who you are in that sense. So just to stick to the topics that you need to stand for as a brand, you write it down, that will work very well. Avinash says Twitter only on Facebook, which is a very interesting point. On Facebook, you're saying Twitter only. So pick your channels with some kind of restraint. Don't go overboard because you won't be able to manage all of them because it takes a lot of time online. But when you actually have your content input pipelines that these are what I need to read on a consistent basis, then your output will also be decent enough. If you start reading everything, then you wouldn't know what to actually output about. That's largely it. I need to go back and watch the match. You can also go and watch the match. Thank you for the time today. Thank you all. Bye.